My name is Isaac Haniff. We're at the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill, and I'm a research assistant in the Song Lab. I'm really interested in the processes in the brain and how neurons are regulated and how they interact with each other. I was born in Toronto, and then when I was like 4 years old, we moved to Charlotte. From a very young age, I've always been interested in science. I used to watch Bill Nye the Science Guy a lot, and I think he's kind of an inspiration to me. Jeff Corwin and Steve Irwin, they were also good. And The Empire Strikes Back, Darth Vader cuts off Luke Skywalker's hand. And then like the next episode, he has the, he's doing this with his hand. He's like looking at his hand, and you can see the mechanical tendons inside just retracting, and they're contracting and expanding, and it works just like a real hand. And I was incredibly surprised. I'm like, well, how can someone have like a robotic hand? It's amazing. It works just like a real one. When the ones that are actually out there, they're very clunky, or they're super expensive, or they don't work nearly as well as the one that you see in the movie. Obviously, that's movie magic, but it's an ideal to strive towards. It made me motivated to pursue biomedical engineering and neural prosthetics, and that's kind of what I'm somewhat doing here in the lab. You know, the very beginning stages of it, acquiring those electrical signals from the nerves and recording them. The first day I came in the lab, Weed was just showing me the benches and introducing me to the people.
Because tomorrow morning we're doing an experiment. We thought about doing an experiment after your presentation.
Me or him?
Him.
Some of the things that you're talking about are going like way over my head.
Bye, Allison.
And I'm like, well, how could I ever like fit in here? But yeah, I was actually kind of surprised that I put it in my CV that I knew how to solder, and I sent that email to Dr. Song to see if she'd accept me into her lab. And she actually contacted one of the grad students here, Reed, about it, and he saw that on the CV, and he was like, wow, this is actually applicable to something we do in lab. And I would never have figured, you know, that they'd be doing soldering in a pharmacology lab. And it just worked out really, really conveniently for me, and also for Reed, I guess. You know, I gave it a shot anyways, and like the next time I went to the lab, like, he gave me things to do. Like, I had to do some genotyping, and he was very, like, you know, he was very patient with me. There's electrodes that are implantable into brains. What I do is I solder the microchips that are attached to the needles of the electrodes. The needle part is the implantable portion, but the chip like processes the information that's coming from the probes. Here we have the third hand holding up the parts of the electrodes that I work on. There's a microscope that I use to look at the parts of the electrode, as you can see. They're very small, so you kind of need a visual aid to help you. The electrodes are made of two parts. Here we have the PCBs, and then what we solder onto them is the connectors, which are in this drawer. Each one of these, they're pretty expensive actually, so I try not to mess them up too badly. Turn it on. Up to a high enough temperature for it to melt the actual solder, which is a metal. And this. Okay. So first you have to add flux, which will let the solder kind of like run freely over the where we need the connections to be made. The pins are really small. The connections you make are, you don't have to add too much to them. I usually like to do this. Cut them off. And you kind of just have to make sure you don't connect consecutive pins to each other. There we go. That's good. For the first one. I have to admit, like everyone in the lab, they're amazing. Chaiyu, Xuan, Andrew, Ting, everyone. They're really good people to work with. I love them. We're hoping that our research in the future will be able to contribute to solutions for like diseases like Alzheimer's or impairments in nerve conduction due to like strokes. To be able to help those people who are going to have Alzheimer's in the future, so that they're not feeling like disabled and unable to do things that they used to do so easily, like maybe forgetting the key somewhere or forgetting to lock doors or something like that, you know, to empower them. I mean, that's the whole reason that we're studying neurogenesis. Science is so huge, and some of these problems, they're in dire need of a solution. So we're just hoping that, 20, 30 years from now, all the research in the world can, mesh together and maybe can find a solution to these kind of disorders. Science is amazing, so I love it. Just a contribution to knowledge is a worthwhile pursuit.